జనతా పార్టీ అధ్యకుడిగా రాజకీయ నేతగా ఆయన ప్రపంచానికి పరిచయం అయితే అంతకంటే ముఖ్యంగా వివాదాస్పద సంచలన వ్యాఖ్యలు చేసే వ్యక్తిగా తాజాగా 2G స్కామ్ ని బయట పెట్టిన కీలక శక్తిగా ఆయన వార్తలోకెక్కారు. ఆయనే డాక్టర్ సుబ్రహ్మణ్య స్వామి. ప్రస్తుతం సాక్షి టీవీతో మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. వెల్కమ్ సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ స్పీకింగ్ విత్ అస్ టుడే. యు బీన్ మేకింగ్ న్యూస్ ఫర్ ద రైట్ రీజన్స్ ఆల్ ద టైమ్.
మై జాబ్ ఇస్ టు డూ మై duty, and sometimes the press takes notice, sometimes the press doesn't take notice.
You've been most recently instrumental in bringing out one of the biggest massive scams in the country, the 2G scam. Do you believe that justice has been done, and all the people that you wanted to nail down have been nailed down?
Well, I wouldn't say justice has been done, but the process of meeting out justice has taken place. What is very heartening is that there was a general impression in the country that people at the top will never be prosecuted, ministers will never go to jail. That process has started, but it's still a long way to go. It will go right to the top, it will go right up to Sonia Gandhi.
Do you believe it will go to Sonia Gandhi?
Absolutely, no question. Sonia Gandhi got the lion's share of the bribe.
And you've been making these allegations time and again about Sonia Gandhi and her sisters, and you have been questioned also on what kind of proofs you have in making these allegations.
Well, you see, the question is proof. Who do I give the proof to? I can give proof to court, and I will give the proof when I file the case. But I don't want to do everything at the same time. I said first Raja must go, then Kanimani must go, then Dayanidhi Maran, then Chidambaram, then I will go to Mr. Vadra, then finally I'll come to Sonia Gandhi. So when I file that case against Sonia Gandhi, that time I'll give proof.
Two down and several more to go then.
Yes, yes, yes. Today I had gone to the trial court, and the trial court has given me now permission to conduct independently of the CBI the case on against Raja and other people in the 2G, and also to make give me permission to argue why Chidambaram should be made an accused in this 2G spectrum, which is will be heard on 15th September in the trial court. And I've also got a petition in the Supreme Court, which is being heard on the 1st of September, why CBI should not be asked to investigate Chidambaram for his culpability.
You are skeptical about the CBI. I mean, even most recently you made comments on the CBI's.
Yeah, the CBI, you see, the thing is that if the CBI is under the monitoring of the court, then there's no problem. They are very professionally good people. But they, for career reasons, they come under the pressure of the government. And they can do anything at any time. So that is the difficulty, not anything else.
Have you heard the precedents to say that the CBI is probably working under political pressure?
Oh, certainly. Look at what they are doing on this Rahul Gandhi's rape case. You see, there's one allegation that in Amethi this had taken place. So the matter has gone to Supreme Court. Now suddenly, out of the blue, the CBI has gone and wanting to be impleaded. Now, this has never happened in the history of India's jurisprudence, that CBI normally is asked by the court to take interest in a case. This is the first time where the CBI says we should also be heard before the case is decided.
And even tracing back, withdrawing red corner notices to Khatochi and several other cases,
absolutely.
How do you view those things?
Well, those are all, the CBI is not at fault. The political authorities are at fault. They are the ones who direct them. CBI obeys them. If they get an order, they obey.
So you won't blame them, but you would blame the system and the political authorities?
Absolutely. See, I know CBI officials, most of them are very professionally good people and they are capable people. But the climate of the country is that everybody, falls in line. Well, look at what's happening in many of the political parties, including Congress. Nobody questions Sonia Gandhi. They execute orders from her.
Why do you think the situation is like this today?
Because we have been brought up that way. We have not yet tasted democracy. This time recently I had written an article where many of our people were wrote to Harvard University, where I teach one in the summer, that I should be prosecuted. Harvard gave a lecture to the Indian government saying that we believe in freedom of speech and Swami has the right to freedom of speech. I mean, I felt ashamed that my government has to be rebuked like this.
When you've said Sonia Gandhi needs to be prosecuted, on what?
She has to be prosecuted on a number of things. I think on Bofors, she has never been questioned. I have a petition pending with the Prime Minister for sanction to prosecute her. On Bofors, she has to be prosecuted for smuggling of antiques from India, including murtis from the temples, the statues from gods, statues from temples, paintings. Then for having received money from KGB.
To what extent?
Well, it doesn't matter, even $1 is enough. But it was in running into several million dollars. Then money, receiving money from Saddam Hussein for oil for food in the oil for food program. Then faking her educational qualification. She's not past fifth class, but she claimed she got a degree from University of Cambridge. Her citizenship papers are not in order. Then, and she enrolled as a voter in India before becoming citizen of India. That was a fraud. Then, of course, during the emergency, she was managing director of Maruti Heavy Engineering, and that was illegal. She was a Benami insurance agent, and that as a foreigner, she had no right to be an insurance agent of public sector insurance agencies.
Allegations of
yes,
banking.
Yes.
You plan to investigate and get...
Naturally, I have to do it because I'm a private citizen. I'm not a head of CBI. I'm not a minister of home affairs or anything like that. So I have to do it within my resources, and these require a lot of painstaking work, and so it will take time. Or tomorrow I come into government, it will be very fast.
Recently you also made some remarks about the state of politics in Andhra Pradesh.
Yes.
Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy.
Yes.
What made you make those remarks? What did you feel?
I'm saying why the Congress party, when there were so many petitions earlier, did not take it up. I mean, Congress party cannot treat CBI and the investigation by CBI, whether it is through court or otherwise. They cannot, at the whim of their thing, decide that they will back this and not back that. So there is an atmosphere that CBI is being used as an instrument of Congress party. I do see that the Congress party wants to destroy Jagan Reddy. And
what could be the reason in your view being a...
Because he threatened, now these by-elections have shown what a threat he is to the Congress party. And there are people to me who say, why are you supporting him? He's, when there is a conflict between two people, one of them is misusing power, I have to stand up, you see.
So Sonia Gandhi is misusing power in your view?
What is the big surprise in that? Is it new? It is. It is all over. She is today abroad for medical treatment and nobody is to know where she is, which hospital she is, what is her ailment, what kind of a situation is that? It is ridiculous. Those days when the kings and queens were there, they used to hide their illnesses this way. But today we have a democracy. When the Prime Minister was there for a heart operation, every day there was a bulletin. When Abdul Kalam went, there was a bulletin. When Vajpayee went to get his knee surgery, there used to be a bulletin every day. The President of the United States has bulletins every day. Why this woman should be treated like a queen?
And again, I come back to the fundamental question, Dr. Swami, who is responsible for this situation? How much of accountability does the Prime Minister have in
who is that? You say culture? I would say Mr. Jagan Reddy, somewhere he's decided to fight. Freedom for him because he's decided to fight. And I hope he remains fired, till the end as a fighter. He should not compromise with Sonia Gandhi under any circumstance. This is what people tell me. But at the moment, this is not fair that he should be targeted just because he's a threat to Congress party.
And you do see him as a threat in the forthcoming...
No question about it. There will be no Congress party if Jagan is let free. And I hope he becomes a nationalist. He takes all communities together.
Sonia Gandhi being prosecuted is...
She's the most important. She's the Gangotri. She's Kali Yuga Gangotri.
You've never feared Dr. Swami? I mean...
Why should I fear? Venkateswara is with me.
Coming coming back, although you haven't been following the case in depth, Mr. Jagan's case in depth, where do you see this going? I mean, there's a CBI inquiry going on, and the way the CBI proceeded really fast in a matter of 2 weeks, as though this is the end of the world, having over 2,200 cases pending in court, over 10,000 cases unresolved. Where do you see this whole thing going?
If they hasten, then they'll make mistakes, then you will have an opportunity. But the fact is that the CBI is known to make big bloomers when they are forced to do something. So I'm not prejudging that. But I would say that everybody has a right to be considered innocent till proven guilty. And I don't like this atmosphere, the atmosphere the Congress creates, that whoever they think is guilty and whoever is innocent, no matter how guilty they are, is innocent.
And you continue to live on with the hope that you will get Sonia Gandhi?
I will not let go. I have never let go. I did it with Ramakrishna Hegde, brought it to a final conclusion. I did it with Jayalalitha. I've done it with so many people. I never let go.
You've never feared Dr. Swami? I mean,
why should I fear? Venkateswara is with me.
Venkateswara is with you?
Yes.
After all, you can't do these things unless you have divine blessings. And if you do it for yourself, then God will, there won't be divine.
So do you see this as a fight between good and evil, or how do you?
I think it's a way for purification of India. India must now become a world power. It cannot become a world power unless corrupt people are brought to book.
Sonia Gandhi being prosecuted is?
She's the most important. She's the Gangotri. I'm sorry to use the word Gangotri, but in Kali Yuga I can use it. She's Kali Yuga Gangotri. Everything emanates from her. She has got at least 100,000 crores abroad. It's not fair. She's spending $40,000 a day for maintenance of her families and relatives for food and other things in New York just now. Who's paying for that?
Dr. Swami, can you throw some more light on the KG Basin issue?
Well, that's a question of pricing. You know, it is, after all, the people of Andhra have a right to a proper royalty. And a certain price was fixed, and the Ambanis had it. It appears to me that this is a scandalous affair. We must, you know, and the CAG report has now coming. And I think it's a case which I will be very interested in taking up.
Lastly, Dr. Swami, you've also made allegations on Sonia Gandhi's sister.
Yes, two sisters.
Two sisters taking 18,000 crores each?
Yeah, in the 2G, the total kickbacks for Sonia Gandhi is 60% of 60,000 crores. And that means 36,000 crores. So she's divided it between the two sisters who have deposited in Macau in China, which is probably the safest place today in the world. And these two sisters are now divorced, and they keep company in Dubai, which is against India's interests. So they are foreigners, and I don't think they should be allowed to come into India. Nowadays they are calling up officials like Pulok Chatterjee and saying, do this. It's all very wrong. So their sisters will also be prosecuted, in my opinion.
You get your information from, I'm sure, various sources, because you're saying it so authoritatively. I mean,
well,
I'm sure
have been proved wrong so far. You tell me one issue I've been proved wrong. When I first raised the 2G issue, everybody said this is all nonsense. What is he talking about? How can it be? Nobody knows this. How does he know? I proved right. The Supreme Court has upheld whatever I've said. So people want to know how I get my information. Now, I'm not going to reveal my sources. But I can tell you, as far as 2G, the first source was the private secretary of Raja. He came to this room and told me everything. His name is Ashirvad Amachari.
And he came and told you everything?
He told me everything. So there are people like that, courageous people, who don't mind, you know, the risk to their lives and so on. So I protect them. I don't reveal them till they agree to be revealed. I've got resources, sources everywhere. I have, after all, my background is like that. I have students from Harvard who are there all over the world. They happen to be ministers in various countries. They happen to be chairman of banks, chairman of corporations. Harvard is a place like that, you see, where the best come and then they go and occupy very high positions. So I have a vast amount of sources. People think that I have no support. I can't do all this without support, but my support I keep secret. Most people keep their friends public and their enemies secret. I do the opposite. I make my enemies public and keep my friends secret.
And currently your enemies are, needless to say?
I have only 1 point program just now, Sonia Gandhi, nothing else. If Jagan is on this issue clear, he should come out.
And fight.
And fight. Because it is a fight for the survival.
We're just walking out of the party?
In a democracy? Party challenging her, and she cannot. The people like whoever previously challenged her, his protection lies in coming out openly. He should tell the country the truth. So he has a role to play.
Dr. Swami, you've told us a lot of things today, a lot of food for thought for all those watching this chat.
Yes. Well, I'm a great admirer of Andhra Pradesh, the Telugu people. I have relatives who are Telugus. I come from a village in Madurai, which is a Telugu-speaking village. So, because the Tirumala Nayaka, for whom our family was the Prime Minister and the Commander-in-Chief of the Army, he was a Telugu. I think the Telugu people, if they come out on the street, nobody can stop them.
Nobody can stop them. And that starts with Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy.
He can do it. He's got the capacity. And he owes it to the people of Andhra.
Sir, how do you see the Supreme Court in this issue, not interfering, not wanting to interfere with the High Court?
Naturally. They want, when an investigation starts, they'll never interfere. Wild allegations in an FIR are enough for the Supreme Court to say.
Thank you very much, Dr. Swami, for speaking to Sakshi.
Bye. Namaskar.